Six factors that affect your credit score and exactly what they mean. If you are looking to find out more about credit scores and what affects it, then stay tuned. Hi, it's Juju Grijab. I release tons of real estate content to help you understand and stay informed about the real estate market. If you are new here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you can be notified every time I post a new video. Today, we'll be talking about the six factors that affect your credit score. Let's jump on it. Credit scores can range between 200 and 850, with scores above 620 considered desirable for obtaining a mortgage. But what are the factors that really determines those numbers? First and foremost is the length of your credit history. The earlier you start, the better, because how long an account has been open will determine whether it is risky or not. Just so you have an idea of how this works, if you are striving to have a perfect score of 850, you would need to have a credit history of at least 9 years. Next is your payment history, which includes whether you have paid your bills on time, if you have any bankruptcies, liens, or collections, pretty much any activity that can impact your credit history. Third is the number of accounts you have. There is a myth that the more accounts you have, the less your credit score will be. That's totally untrue, especially considering that in order to have a perfect score of 850, you must have at least 21 or more reporting lines of credit. The reason why the total amount of accounts you have is important is because the lenders want to see that you can manage effectively all types of credits. Fourth is credit utilization. How much you utilize your credit can have a huge impact on your score. In order to attain and maintain a good credit score, it is recommended that you keep your credit utilization to about 10 to 29% of your credit limit. That means if your credit card limit is 2,000, you will want to make sure that at least 71% of your loan is paid off before the end of the month and the next statement comes in. You can achieve this by spreading your credit card expenditure into different accounts and keeping the utilization rate for each one at a maximum of 29%. Next is derogatory marks, which are missed payments. Each payment results in a derogatory mark. So before you miss a payment, call the creditor and try to make an arrangement. You might be able to come to a resolution that avoids a derogatory mark on your credit history. Last is new inquiries, which happens every time you apply for credit. There are two types of inquiries, soft and hard. A soft inquiry is when your credit is checked, but won't be used to accumulate debt, such as those for rental applications. Now, a hard inquiry are the ones in which credits will be accumulated, such as credit cards, mortgage, and car loans, and those can have a huge impact on your credit score. The good thing about credit inquiries, though, is that they do disappear from your credit history within 2 years compared to everything else that remains for 7 years. So there you go. I just gave you the six factors that affect your credit score and what each one of them means to you, the consumer. Now, if you want to get more real estate information and education, be sure to sign up to my blog to receive a real estate guidebook for buyers and sellers. The link will be in the description box below. And if this video brought you some kind of value, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up so I know to make more videos like this. And let me know in the comments below if you have any question and what kind of real estate videos you would like to see more. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.